evening, everybody. So I'm going to talk to you about one of my favorite painters, William Kurelek. So when I was a young boy, I had these two books called A Prairie Boy's Summer and A Prairie Boy's Winter. And they had these beautiful pictures in them of boys playing, doing sports, doing chores. A lot of the time the chores were like really onerous, like mucking the stable or shoveling the driveway. It reminded me a lot of the pain that I was going through as a young man, my dad making those chores. And it kind of, the work spoke to me. Later, I worked at the Art Gallery of Ontario and I came into contact with Kurelek's work again and was kind of exposed to the full breadth of the kind of stuff that he painted. And it was not just nostalgic images of the prairies and Saskatchewan and Manitoba. There was a lot more going on. I want to tell you a little bit about that. So Kurelek is from Manitoba originally, very skilled painter. His parents were Ukrainian, did not speak English, so he felt lonely and ostracized as he grew up. He went to OCAD in Toronto, tried to learn how to paint, and oh my gosh, this grows so fast. Okay. And went to Mexico, he tried to like learn from Diego Rivera, ended up in the asylum in Maudsley in London, England, where he was suicidally depressed. But this is where he painted this piece here, which is called The Maze, which depicts Kurelek's own head split open, lying in a field on the prairies. And inside his skull are contained all these different sort of demons that kind of torture him. And he's a little mouse in the center of the maze. So Kurelek came back to Toronto. He was discovered by Avram Isaacs, who was told that he's sort of the Canadian Peter Bruegel. And Kurelek became famous painting these nostalgic scenes of life on the prairies. He also, when he became a painter at Maudsley, converted to Roman Catholicism. And he used the money from his popular work to do like a series on the Passion of the Christ, the Stations of the Cross. This one is very controversial. This is Yonge Street, and at the time all these sex clubs were opening up, and Kurelek railed against this by depicting a combine tractor beheading all of these people who are lined up to go to these sex clubs. So he felt very strongly. He was also terrified of nuclear war. So he depicts all these scenes of life on the prairies, but in the distance you can see there's a mushroom cloud and a farmer running. This next one is quite dramatic. It's the city of Hamilton. This is called This Is Nemesis. This is the city of Hamilton being destroyed by a nuclear explosion. And this hangs in the Hamilton Art Gallery. Kurelek's studio was a bomb shelter in the basement of his home in Toronto. However, you know, his work's not completely dark. He loved Canada. He traveled across Canada in this little tiny Volkswagen. This is a painting of the prairies that he does. I love how he captures the sky in this painting. It's wonderful. His best work, I find, is really reflective of Canada's landscapes and particularly its peoples. He's done stuff on Ukrainian Canadians, on Jewish Canadians. This is from a set of paintings he did on the Inuit. And like this is a wonderful one he's done of the Northern Lights, Aurora Borealis, on the prairies. So just depicting those, the skies at night on the prairies. The wonderful thing about Kurelek, and this is kind of what allowed him to endure and sustain himself as a painter, is he also builds frames, and he builds the frames for all his paintings. You can see in this one, he's got a painting of kids playing on a snow fort and, you know, fighting each other, and then the frame of the painting, oh geez, I only had 17 slides, so I got a little bit more time. In the frame, he's depicting himself lying on his bed, listening to a record. And he's thinking, you can just see that he's thinking about this childhood that he's had. So his best works, I find, have that sort of reflective, nostalgic quality, and they are a bit sad as well. So anyway, super interesting painter. I encourage you to go to the Art Gallery of Ontario. He's got a whole room dedicated to his work where you can see this combination of life on the prairie and wild Catholic didacticism. Really cool stuff. Check it out.